Nice and professional. Alright, let's go. We got grand finals. We got a DAT team grand finals going on now.
But that Monday meltdown.
Yeah.
CEO privilege. Putting themselves in grand finals.
So, Carnage coming through losers bracket. Being the likes of Zone, Calamari, and La Crescia. Yep.
You see, like, the respect that Carnage already has in this matchup. Like, usually it's him going for, like, down throw to back air.
Yeah.
He goes for it there. But, like, before he was just going for, like, down throw to shield.
Yeah.
Because he didn't want to risk getting hit by Luma at all.
But Luma is dead now, so can go for those follow ups. Looks like he down aired into the ground there, got punished. Run out that side B.
Looking for some huge. Just choosing to chase down Luma.
Destroying Luma.
This is exactly how you have to play against public characters. Rosalina is at best a mid tier without Luma. Look at his back already. And you instantly see just Carnage homing in on Luma.
Yeah, that space fair by Peach is definitely very important in this matchup. When gliding very close to the ground. Hovering, sorry. Carnage, he's going for a lot of up smash. Yeah.
He's going for a lot of smashes generally. Like, something that we haven't
done. Okay. I think Carnage probably looking for a space fair, but I guess he flubbed. Not quiet.
Good DR. Just floating my legs.
Yep.
Yeah. Nothing Rosalina can do about that.
Nah.
Is that a stitch? No, it's like.
Yeah. Yeah, it is. It's a stitch. It's in the ground. Pick it up. Nah, it's gone.
It's gone.
DXM seemed very comfortable in choosing to go for the stage pressure instead.
Smash just calling there
we go.
And that is game one.
Going game one to DX17. Look like in the end he's just putting up more pressure. And that's basically what won him the game at the end of the day.
A lot of DX17's conversions that were just coming off reading what Carnage was doing.
Yeah.
Like, at the end there it was an up smash on knowing that he was going to side beat into him. And Carnage just running it straight back to Omega Palutena's.
Alright, here we go.
Saying, like, it wasn't the stage that was a problem. I'm just going to outplay you.
Yeah. Sometimes you don't need to change stages. You just need to adapt and change what you do. Okay, he's going to punish that whiff forward air. But not too harshly.
Nothing to choose between them right now. And again, that side beam right in front of the XM.
Yeah. Pivoting away and getting a down tilt. Destroys Luma. Falling out of dash attack. Oh, okay, nice bait. Realizing that he probably would have done gravitational pull, but re-crabs the turnip and throws out a forward air. But now Carnage is in a bad spot.
Luma jumps on ledge, just manages to roll past that up smash. He's gonna try and find his way away from this ledge and back into neutral. He gets Luma out of there, he's a big threat in the ledge. And Luma's quiet.
And Luma comes back. Looked like Khan has definitely opted to put more pressure onto Rosa instead of killing Luma there. Which I'd say is probably worth it because Luma was on the left side.
In that situation, there was a good chance of getting a start.
Yeah, yeah. Oh, wow.
Booty bumps.
And Rosa.
That's the same to Rosa.
Oh, my God.
So sneaky on that recovery from the XMT.
He like, there was like that slight delay before he grabbed the ledge. That was very vital. Oh, crucial air dodge. Up air. Very close first stock. See if Ben will extend his lead or not. Definitely can die to a forward air.
Kaiba's gone.
Yep, Khan's just chance, but he is off stage.
He's just looking for that corner. Yeah. I don't think it would kill cross stage quite yet.
Nah. It looked like DX had it scouted out.
That led to that of Destiny.
But that back air takes it, yep. Oh, the stitch goes to waste, unfortunately, for our Carnage.
No, big damage to Luma, so now it's going to body as it's coming. And there he goes.
There he goes.
Carnage just dancing around in DX17's face right now. Just controlling
that. Ooh, that forward air just missing. DX answering a forward air of his own. Oh, nice. Bait once again. Carnage really catching on to these gravitational pulls. Hits him with the frying pan.
Seems like Carnage has started to adapt by just throwing a lesson on.
Yeah.
Like, the last couple of neutralized things, he's won just by dancing around, using movement right in DX17's face.
Yeah, definitely. There goes Luma, nice F smash. Up smash, not quite. Perfect DI coming in there. Oh my god. Carnage going for the double art smash. And that back air comes in.
Another smash.
Another one. This time the golf club taking it.
We are now at 1-1 in the Batsy mirror match.
Yeah, so a lot of forward smashes coming out, clearing out Luma and Rosa. The golf club takes it, so now we've got ourselves in a 1-1 situation. Claiming that this is his favourite stage.
Enables him to slow the pace of the game down to a point where he's happy.
Yeah.
He just took choice right not to throw or even run away. And just let Luma in out of the jump grab.
Oh, oh! Damn!
Just calling out that upper.
Jeez.
Overcommitting.
Excellent umbrella, or parasol, I should say, by Carnage. Realizing that he can punish that. So now he has a tremendous lead. A 4 air taking out both of them.
DX17 just stuck in the corner here. Carnage's corner pressure is so, so strong.
Yep, definitely. He'll throw fares at you, throw turnips at you. Try and read a roll. Up smash!
And that was a 1 minute game. Almost exactly.
Yeah. Excellent play there.
And that is Carnage going 2-1 up.
Well, I wasn't expecting that. Carnage one game away from resetting the bracket.
I mean, when something like that parasol off the top happens, that just swings the momentum so heavily.
Yeah, definitely. But we're going back to Duck Hunt. Carnage not minding to go here, I suppose.
I mean, he just...
Yeah. Yeah. There wasn't even much stage interaction, really.
No.
So maybe that's why.
Basically as
FD. Yeah.
DX17 not risking this game.
Yeah, a bit more patient that time. He gets forward air though.
He's got no jump right now, he's gonna have to unbeat the ledge.
What's the south spot? Perhaps accidentally grabbing the ledge.
He's gonna have to unbeat.
Oh wow.
I
thought we were gonna see a patented roll read there, but not that time.
Sending Carnage off stage, setting up this off stage situation. Looking for that F-smash 2 frame and not getting it.
Oh, Luma getting in the way of the rapid jab. Managed to side beat both of them.
Carnage really just threatening the ledge itself. Like,
yeah.
If the DX17 had held ledge for a second too long, he was dead.
My god, both players whiffing an up smash. That was very close. Oh wow, I'm not even sure what move that was. But it sent, maybe, but it sends Carnage back off stage, and so does that dash attack.
Forward air!
Just about takes it from across the stage. Carnage looking pretty comfortable to reset his bracket. But he could die right now. If DX makes the right plays, and he does.
Only 19% in it now, after that stop.
DX deciding to chase him once again with the up airs. Works out in his favour this time. No parasol today.
Mine's just becoming more and more aggressive as these hits go on.
Yeah.
You're seeing fewer and fewer turnips coming out from him.
He was doing well with the turnip gravitational pull baits though. But it looks like DX17's kind of caught on to that.
Yeah.
It looks like he's still throwing out turnips sort of off stage, just to sort of delay his recovery.
Or in situations like that, where he can't really challenge with his own like aerials.
Yeah, the turnips. The turnips force him to recover low as well, and exploit that recovery. But here we go, Carnage with the stage control. Ooh, okay, he goes for the side B. Stitch face once more. Is he gonna catch it again? Yep. Ben wants none of that stitch face. It disappears. Ooh, cheeky neutral air, I think that was coming out.
The toad just gets Carnage to the ground safely.
Gets spewed with that toad gas. Oh, that fair, nearly taking it. Nearly connected, I should say. Forward air, the time he gets it.
Zan's just chilling up there like, yo, that was a pretty sweet bracket reset.
Sweet.
Right.
Yeah,
first
Carnage resetting it, 3-1.
We go into set two now.
Put an L next to DX as well, I suppose.
And we are starting set two on
that. Yep.
What am I doing?
There we go. Do you want to put set two as well next to grand finals?
That's fine.
Alright then. This is set two for future La Crescia shows reference. Well, I mean, it will be one video anyway.
Yeah, exactly.
But yep, we're back to Duck Hunt.
Both most neutral stage in the game.
Both players have no qualms to go here, I suppose. They must have gentlemen to it, because it is the first.
I mean, it's DX17's favourite stage, and Carnage did just win on it, what?
Twice, yeah. So clearly they must have gentlemen to it, game one. Maybe we'll see a whole Duck Hunt set.
DX17 just crossing up Carnage there. Setting that up into this offstage situation.
Oh, he knew he was going to F smash.
DX17 really getting a little bit predictable with these edge guards. Good clear into the ledge there.
Okay, gets a Luma up smash. Well, I feel like he definitely could have punished that with the Toad counter. But it doesn't quite do it. Okay, DX not getting hit by these Peach tricks. Wow, it just loops over him. But now he finds himself off stage.
This game, it seems like DX17's Luma is staying alive a lot longer than it has been previously.
Yeah, slightly.
Perhaps Carnage not to like to get quite as much.
Well, managed to get that last hit down air.
And there goes.
He still gets punished for it though.
But right now that's a worthwhile trade. Because DX17 just can't press on the ledge in quite the same way.
Yeah. Oh, wow. Carnage dancing around him, but he does get grabbed. He mashes out of it, though.
Hiding in the grass.
Ooh, the slight elevation from the dog nearly made him die, to be honest.
Just using the tree to get back to stage safe. Get away from that ledge.
Luckily for Carnage, he gets the sour spot of up here. Forward tilt. Forward tilt? Yeah, it's forward tilt.
Yeah.
So, oh jeez. Okay, I thought Lumra was Mr. Sand for a second. He's like, he's just white.
Carnage, where are you going?
Oh,
Carnage! What was that? It's just like floating in a very vulnerable position for so long. And DXMG taking full advantage.
Although Carnage is building up this lead now. Oh, God. Rosa and Lumra. There we go. Carnage looking very comfortable now. Will he steal this game off stage? DX starting to jump high.
Lumra down there, sending Carnage so far off stage.
Oh, it looked like Ben was gonna punish that float there. Didn't do it though.
DXMT getting the roll rate from ledge, but just missed space in the grab side. The Lumra down tilt. Lumra just.
There we go, just about.
Carnage just clipping Lumra with his parasol there. And it's just being enough to interrupt DX17's ledge trap.
Yeah, it was like. Looked like DX was like pixels away from getting that grab. I'm not sure if Carnage moved himself or Ben just moved. Mistimed it. But that worked out for Carnage's favour.
Now we're going to the fourth game in a row on double.
Yeah.
DXMT just loving this stage. Although, probably not loving its results.
Yeah, that last game could have been anyone's though, to be fair. But Carnage takes it.
It's just one basic mistake at the end
though. Ooh.
DXMT punishing that Toad.
Yeah, decides not to throw out an attack. Wow. Count as Lumra though. And that's it. Quick stock. Just over 30 seconds.
And only 50% on DX17.
Yep, very strong start.
The charm for DX17.
There goes Lumra. Nearly punishing that gravitational pull once more. But he's too late. Oh man.
It feels like these two have both adapted to each other's ledge trapping options.
Yeah.
A lot faster than they've adapted to each other's ledge.
Yeah.
Like they're both getting out of each other's ledge trapping so much easier than they were earlier on in this set. By saying that, DXMT sets straight back off stage.
Carnage driven aggressive up air. Lumra pulls him in for the up smash.
I was about to say it's even, but there's a whole stock difference right now.
Oh, okay. I was going to say he left Lumra alone for a second, but perhaps it was a sliver bait. Maybe he was trying to trick DX17 to think he was going to hit Lumra again, but goes in for the up smash. Very well played there. I'll see you, man. See you for that. Yeah, see if you can use this rage.
I mean, sort of from like game 2 or game 3 of the first set. Like,
oh!
And that's Lumra just.
That cheeky parasol.
All it takes for Pete, just that one mistake, and he can just parasol off the top. Gun is now sitting on max rage.
It's game 2 in. It's 1-0 to Carnage in set 2. DX17 is not far away from death percent. Jeez.
Carnage catching some bad DI there.
DX17 almost. Oh, four there. That's it. Damn. Game 2 going to.
Now we're going to see a fifth game in a row on that. Like, DX17's just lost 4 games in a row on.
Yep.
Is he going to go back to the comfort pick, or is he actually going to counter pick?
I don't know. It looks like we're having a full-on set on Duck Hunt.
Yeah. Just going back to Duck Hunt saying, I'm comfortable here, like. I don't know what happened in that last game, or the game before, or like any of the games before that.
Yeah. Carnage just really picking his spots, the closing moments of that last game. Using that rage to kill Rosa quite early.
I feel the adaptations made in that last game as well.
Was he's out, Irfan.
Keeping Luma out of the equation a lot more.
Yeah. Chasing DX in the air now. Retracts that Luma before the F smash could connect. Then knowing he was going to take care of that Luma. Managed to grab him.
Towards the ledge.
Up there, no double. Another stitch. Oh, wow. That really evened up this first stock.
Yeah.
Although Carnage with the stage control now. Had to re-grab the ledge.
Not quite enough to kill. Oh, that up air just calling out that risky umbrella. Or parasol.
Very risky parasol indeed. DX17 punishing with a nice and simple up air. Dash attack will take it now, I think. Yeah, Carnage with the empty hops, the little trickeries with the hover, the float, or whatever it's called. Dash attacks Luma, not quite the target he wanted, but still good.
DX17 now put on ledge. Turn up just missing.
Ooh, I'd have loved to have seen a neutral air there from Carnage.
Looking for the second.
He went for it.
That parasol he got in game 3 of the last set.
Dog assist! The dog assist! Wow.
And it took 5 games, but DX17 finally took a game on that time.
Yeah.
And in dominant fashion with that 2 stop.
That doggo. But that dog being a good boy.
He's a good doggo.
Oh, we're switching. Alright.
Carnage
now
going to
Omega Palutena's
temple.
Definitely been a wild 2 sets. Some matches going quite one-sided, some very close. Let's see how this one goes. Carnage still 1 game away from taking this whole event. This whole tournament. But he blocks the Luma neutral air, but not Rosa.
DX17 going very risky, going off stage there. It's now just being pinned to the ledge by Carnage for it.
Pulls out the second air dash attack. That would have been good for Carnage, but now he finds himself off stage.
DX17 just hovering in the areas, trying to see if Carnage can do anything risky. The neutral air is going to take Carnage's first stock.
I think that's forward air.
Forward air.
Yeah, forward air a Carnage before Carnage's forward air of himself could come out. Showing that frame data advantage.
Top tier privilege.
Gets a falling forward air to down smash. Carnage in a bad spot, but he managed to roll through all of that.
Yes, the down air stays spike. The DX17 doing good job keeping his jump, but the forward air is still going to take the stock.
Just about take that stock.
Fully charging that forward smash there. So much pressure.
Ooh, that forward air nearly. That forward smash nearly gets connecting. An ill advised toad.
Being very risky. Running. Not even attempting to challenge off stage, choosing to win.
He does this time. Doesn't work out.
Gets the spike. Doesn't confirm off it. Risky with
falling out of Rose's dash attack, ironically.
Up throw. Looking for the up air, but doesn't quite get it. I'm good DI to get out of it.
Yeah. Peach having good enough aerial drift as well. Finds himself off stage once more, though.
Bats Luma away. Yes, legend. Luma jab is going to take it.
Luma jab. DX banning stages as Connish flies into Blasso. See you, Justin.
We are now going into game 5. DX17 perhaps on track to reverse 3-0.
Yeah. You just can't tell who's going to win, really. At some point, you think one person's going to win. But then, the other player turns it around.
Connish taking a moment and then deciding to go to Battlefield. Thinking maybe the platforms are going to help me a lot more here for the flat, like flatter stages of that booty bump is gonna just kick out Luma. But unlike a lot of other Roses, DX17 doesn't shy away when he loses Luma. He stays very much in your face. Using that movement, that's just bait out the toad.
Gets the 2-frame, or just before the 2-frame. Not this time. Does get the last hit.
DX17 just managed to get his shield up, not covering Luma.
Yeah, still a worthwhile F smash coming in from Carnage. See if he capitalizes right now on this Lumaless Rosa, but Carnage is now trying to approach. Slips in the back air. There we go.
Very risky.
Looks like Carnage knew he was going to throw out an aerial.
DX17 just falling slightly short there. And Carnage is sat in a very good place to take this game 5 and this one. Luma's gone. He's way out of there now.
Ooh, no up smash read.
DX17 might be starting to fish a little bit to try and even up these stock.
Okay, that loop and down there slipping in. Yeah, Carnage timing that side B perfectly to catch the end lag there, it looked like. And now Carnage is once again in advantageous position. And there goes Luma.
Now he's got the stock lead, Carnage is playing much more defensive and forcing DX17 into these very risky approaches.
Looked like Carnage perhaps knew that he was going to roll behind. Forward air not quite connecting. Forward air sending Luma, both of them, way across the stage. Well, not so much Luma. Okay. Oh wow, Toad coming in. Woo! That nearly took it. Rage Toad, everyone.
DX17 now at 125%. Any strong hit here.
Oh, I was just going to say, I feel an up smash coming. Mashes out of it. Yeah. I think dash attack will take it now, to be honest, with his max rage. Yeah. Lot of whiffs.
Down there,
nearly taking
it. Not quite killing Luma there. Just pinned in the corner by this little star.
And the last hit of up air takes it for Carnage. Nicely done. Oh, that was a very long 2 sets.
Yeah.
And Carnage winning that Monday Meltdown 82.
82 indeed.
In game 5.
GG's.
Well played to everyone.